All right, ladies, gentlemen, gamers, and fellow TikTok enjoyers, welcome back. Welcome back to another TikTok reaction video where I react to all the videos I find that are depressing and make me think we are in the dark dimension. So, after the amazing success of the first video and the thousands upon thousands of fans begging for more, I decided to make another one in this hopefully long-lasting series. So, yet again, I didn't get too many opinions, but I would love to hear what you guys think of this, how I should do it going forward, and what should be changed, what you like, what you dislike, and the whole shebang. So, I'll also repeat this probably at the end too, but I stream every day at twitch.tv/Tecnics channel. You can come over there and watch me and interact with me live. But anyway, back to the point. I might sound a little lethargic, and that is because I made way too much pasta for dinner. And I'm trying to eat it all, and I couldn't. And I'm a little full now. And I thought, what better way to digest some things than to react to videos? So that's what we're gonna be doing today. So hopefully, this is gonna be a while. I don't know how long, but we're gonna go through a couple of videos again. I'm gonna try and shy away from the long ones unless people say they want me to do that. I can look at the long ones for sure. And I'm gonna hopefully by the end of it digest some food and be able to eat more food. But anyway, without further ado, I thought we would start a little lighthearted about this nice little video. So I've seen this a couple times already, and I think it just speaks for itself. I think it truly shows how this society is, what it's become. And the best part about it is the internet is a very good equalizing factor. It's a very good disseminator of information. The problem is, there's knowing and then there's doing. So even though we know, can we actually do? And I'll get more to that after we watch, but without further ado, here we go. Oh shit, oh yeah, oh the US, oh shit. There's a lot of shit in here, so you have to pay attention. Oh, PSYOPs, oh! Oh yeah, no, not the people's interests, hell no. Yeah, ooh, Look at everyone owning everything. Everything is owned by the common few. Oh, yeah, that's us. Oh, the advertiser's money. Oh, we want that. The working class? No. That's not what sells. No. Get that out of here. Fire that guy. Get him out of here. Oh, yeah, no, we can't talk about those people. Those people pay our bills. Oh, no, they employ us. Self-censorship. Oh yeah, take him out. Take him out. Ooh! Look at that. Oh yeah. Do the advertisers like that? Yes, they do. Give him money. Let him raise the ladder. Let him climb the corporate ladder. Oh god, the media companies. Oh no, not Cambridge Analytica. Oh no! Wait, what is that? No! Our data! No! Oh shit! Look at that! Look at that! Look at all those clients! Holy shit! Oh my god! Oh! Oh! Holy shit! Look at all those people. Look at all of them. Oh! Go right ahead. Come right in. Oh yeah, give them all the money. Look at this. It's the American way! So anyway, there was a lot of stuff in there that you might have missed. We're not really gonna go over it. This isn't really an in-depth look at video. It's more just of a reaction slash I'm gonna show you guys video. But yeah, look at all this shit. It's the American way, right? Let's look at the end here. All over the world, wherever there are capitalists, freedom of the press means freedom to buy up newspapers, to buy writers, to bribe, buy, and fake public opinion for the benefit of the bourgeoisie, the bourgeois, said by Lenin. So, again, I'm gonna put the disclaimer out here. I'm not trying to portray any certain political views, even though one in particular, and I'll come out and I'll speak the devil's name here. I'll just outright say it. Socialism is very heavily inspired in these. It's definitely pushed a lot. I'm not necessarily a socialist. I'm not necessarily a capitalist. I'm not necessarily anything. I don't know what the fuck I am. So, there's that. But definitely, if not socialist pushing, it's definitely anti-capitalist. And capitalism, I would say nowadays, we've been seeing the extremes of it. But I don't mean to push any agenda out there, and these ideas do not reflect my own. I'm just, you know, reacting to it. I probably should have put that in the beginning, but whatever. But yeah, so a lot of different stuff in here that's being shown that, you know, the sad reality of it is, you know, we take it as a joke, right? Look, elections influenced in all of these places, and I know someone personally who has verified some of these at least, right? Like, this is sad, but it's true. The crazy part is, it's fucking true. Like, look at this. Look at this. PSYOPs. Pro-America social media PSYOP. Like, what the fuck? But anyway, there's that. So that just shows how evil the government is, how everything is influenced. And I will say, personal anecdote here, for me. Me taking the best major ever in college, media, I've definitely learned a lot about how the government, at the very least, if not other people, definitely influences public opinion. It's the way they got us into wars, it's the way they funded stuff, it's the way they changed public perception to allow certain things to be done. It is actually insane and crazy how much effort and time and thinking and science goes into just swaying public opinion. Because if you convince the public that they need it, they're gonna want it. But anyway, I thought that was a pretty cool thing to start off with. Let's see what else there is. Your rent's going up by 50. I don't remember if I showed this one, but I don't think I did. But this one's a good one too.
15%. Am I getting 15% more housing?
No.
Silly, but I am using YieldStar.
It's
made by the company RealPage that ingests bucket loads of data about rent prices in this neighborhood and across the country, and then uses artificial intelligence to analyze that data and suggest the maximal rent increase I should ask for to yield the most profit from all of my tenants.
Yeah, because rent prices aren't high enough. For real.
The product was quoted as saying, the problem when humans set rent is that sometimes they let their empathy or mathematically as much as they possibly can.
Jesus Christ.
That problem. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
There are several open class action lawsuits accusing YieldStar of breaking antitrust laws.
But they haven't been settled.
They're all using it. It does basically mean that they're all looking at each other's prices and agreeing to use the same internal calculus to set their own, which is how collusion works.
But we were just going to ignore that.
So
yep.
I'm in the clear for now. I'm sorry. I blacked out for a second. Why are you here?
That was a really good transition, by the way, to loop it. But basically, I don't know if we saw this. I'm pretty sure we didn't. I'm making up a way to filter out what we have seen and what we haven't. And I'll sort of do that in the background. I didn't finalize it yet, so we might end up repeating some stuff. If so, you know, it is what it is. If not, then this is the first time we've seen it. I like how Alpaca commented, by the way. Literally, Alpaca commented. But anyway. Yeah, this is kind of sick. I mean, we already have a big crisis in this country with homelessness, with rent not being affordable. Literally, minimum wage in a lot of places in the U.S. If you make minimum, if you work a full-time job, you cannot afford, if you spend no money on anything else, no money on transportation, no money on eating, no money on anything luxurious, even just, you know, hobbies, literally no money to even get to work. If you use 100% of your paycheck to try and pay rent in certain areas, even in the area I'm in, even in the good old NYC Bronx, right? Not even Manhattan, where things are, you know, gonna cost you your whole generation of family's kidneys. Even in the Bronx, where things are supposed to be cheap, 100% of your monthly paycheck will not cover your month rent. So it's like, what the fuck are we supposed to do? I don't know. But that was a pretty good one. You know, very depressing, but pretty good.
I'm literally 6 months into my first corporate job, and I already want to quit.
Oh, she's hot.
People have to understand this new generation of workers, they are not cut out for the monotony of a corporate office job anymore.
Oh.
There was a study that was conducted. It was a mental health comparison of people who worked manual labor jobs.
Ooh.
In comparison to people who worked corporate office jobs.
Corporate slave jobs.
The manual labor workforce has a more positive outlook on life in comparison to people who work in corporate office jobs. And that is because office jobs are physically, mentally, and emotionally draining. Some would say office jobs are honestly harder than manual labor jobs because
ooh,
you sit in one place all day for five to sometimes
that's
six
what
months
I do. That's what I do. I've done it for over 8 months.
Routine,
oh, yeah.
You and cause you to be more depressed than any other job.
Wow. All right, so let's talk about that one. So this one definitely hits close to home for me. Obviously, being in a corporate sort of setting, I have my own cubicle and whatnot, even though I'm a glorified mailman. It's definitely, I could see some truth to this. This is where I could see a lot of pushback from older generations of people being like, oh, you know, you guys just don't want to work this, and that. They're so disconnected. It's fucking disgusting. I can't even fully blame them though, because they grew up in a different time. What can you say, right? But I'll tell you this. The one thing I will admit is I do feel like, I mean, he said there was a study,
Six
right? Let me
months
re-see
into my
this.
first.
People have to understand this new generation of
Let me see
workers, they're
if he
not fed
references the
up with the
study.
monotony of a corporate office job anymore. There was a study that was conducted. It was a
Okay,
medical
so he's
study.
just saying there was a study that was conducted. I'd love to cite his sources, but we don't have the time or patience for that. But let's just take him at his word here, right? So mental health for sure will definitely get impacted in what I call the prison cube of what is a cubicle of an office job. I feel like the only time it doesn't get impacted is when you're in a very, very good environment, which let's be honest is very rare because everyone hates their fucking job. Or when you're at the very top of the ladder, where let's just say you do have a cubicle, but you're making, 100K plus or 200K plus. At that point, I don't think you're gonna be depressed because you're making a shit ton of money or you like what you're doing. But most of the time, for most people, I feel like corporate office jobs are just against human nature. It's against what we're supposed to be like. Manual labor is not that good either. He's kind of painting a wrong picture where, like, oh, manual labor is so good. On average, I could probably guess that people who do manual labor are happier than corporate office workers for sure. I remember there was something told to me recently about this term called going postal. Now, going postal is a term where you just go so crazy from an office job that you just break, you just go crazy. You either like murder someone or you do something so outlandish that like you're like insane. You go postal, you start like an office fight or you wreck the office. You just become very violent because you've had enough. Your mind has had enough. Now, I think in manual labor jobs, not only does it rely more on communication between people, so you're actually interacting with people. I'll tell you this, right? In my corporate office job, I barely interact with anyone. I can go my whole day without speaking to another human soul of a coworker or anyone. I could speak to clients, sure, but those interactions aren't good. They actually are negative. But overall, manual labor jobs, they require a lot more intercommunication between people and it fosters a lot more interaction. And just moving around and getting exercise in general is way better on the body than just sitting down for 8 hours, which is not what the human body was meant to do. But manual labor ain't that pretty either, because it could definitely lead to a lot of health problems. It's also probably pretty miserable, depending on the pay and depending on the heavy lifting, because at the end of the day, it's a physical job. But even though both of them suck, I do think manual labor is slightly better as long as it's done correctly. But anyway, let's see the next one.
It's no secret that student workers barely make enough money to eat. So when
Okay, we got a lot to say about this one, but let me keep it going.
these students started asking for more, Temple University started cracking down. 750 student workers went on strike
That's
to
a
ask for
lot of
better
students.
paying work conditions. They didn't get a raise, but they did get this
Oh,
email.
and I wonder what it
As a result of
says.
your participation in the Tugs of Strike, your tuition remission has been removed for spring semester. You now
Bruh.
owe the full balance listed in TU Pay due by Thursday, March 9th. This means they
Holy
want the
moly.
full tuition and they're giving students only a month to pay it and they'll fine you
Bruh.
$100 if you're late. This is absolutely illegal because interfering with an employee's right to engage in union activities is a violation of federal law.
But
Temple
does
knows these
anyone
students don't have any
care?
money because they've been paying them shit wages, and they know
Wow.
they can't meet these fees. This is a
Holy
blatant
moly.
pressure tactic to punish students for speaking up. If I was this
Jesus.
student, I would take this email straight to an employment attorney or the NLRB. It's
Okay. There is so much to be said about this one video. There's so many topics that were touched on. This little TikTok right here, absolutely fucking amazing. I really outdid myself sending this to myself. But my sweet God, let's go through this piecemeal.
no secret that student
Okay,
workers
let's
barely
go around
make
it a
enough
second
money to
time.
eat. So
So these are student workers that work for the university, right? So the university is paying them while they're also paying the university an arm and a leg to go there. The university is employing them to do work which they're benefiting off of way more than the students are getting. And already they're not getting paid enough probably. Now, historically speaking, I think college is a scam. I think it does have its place in society. However, it's meant to put people, a lot of people, into debt it ruins a lot of people's lives because a lot of people can't even go through it, and then they go into debt and don't even get anything out of it. And then even if you do go through it and you do what I do, which is the best, you know, major ever, media, sometimes you're still shit out of luck because your major is fucking useless. So even if you don't go through it, or even if you do, most of the time, I feel like for most people, it doesn't really mean much anymore. Nowadays, the bachelor's degree, I would feel like, is kind of the new associate's. It's kind of just the standard. Having your master's puts you still above other people. PhD, you know, forget about it. Then you're up in the stars. But back in the day, the baseline level was just a high school diploma. Then it became, okay, you need to at least have your associate's to kind of get something decent. Now it's your bachelor's. Now they expect the bachelor's. I've seen so many job applications where they're like, oh, bachelor's required for entry-level position, where they don't even care what bachelor you have. You just have to have a bachelor. And I'm like, bro, you're asking for a bachelor for an entry-level position, paying minimum wage or goddamn near it. So I had to go through 4 years of school to get minimum? Like, what? It's just crazy. We're in the dark dimension. It's fucking crazy. And this is the best part, right? Students were like, yo, this is bullshit. We don't like colleges taking advantage of us. Let's strike so we can actually try and live a decent life. But and look what happens.
Started asking for more, Temple University started cracking down.
Bruh, they work for Temple University, right? So again, it's just so outlandish to me. You're going to the college. You're paying the college to go there to learn, right? You're paying them a lot of fucking money. And then they're employing you probably, like, at some job where you're doing way more for them than they're giving you. And, like, it's just insane that they fight out against this, and this is what happens.
Ask for better pay and work conditions. They didn't get a raise, but they did get this email.
Like, this is crazy.
As a result of your participation in the Tugza strike,
the Tugza, I like that name, Tugza. So they take away your tuition, which is like... Dude, if you're... I wouldn't be surprised if some college students, like, fucking killed themselves over this. It's crazy.
You now owe the full balance listed in TU Pay due by Thursday, March 9th.
Bruh.
They want the full tuition, and they're giving students only a month to pay it.
So not only do you not have time to pay it, they're putting a time that, like, you have a month to pay it, or else you're gonna owe more, which, you know, $100, what's $100? But to a college student, that's a lot, right? And for the biggest part of this... They're setting up the whole system to be rigged. Like, it's crazy. They're paying them shit wages, like this lovely gentleman says. And then you're paying them shit so you know they can't afford to pay it back. So you're literally just going to make more money off them in the debt. It's fucking crazy. It's ridiculous. We're not going to go through more of this because I feel like I'm spending too much time on this and I want to show a lot different ones. But oh my god, it's so disgusting. And the worst part is it's illegal. Now, this is something I've also dealt with in my personal life. Companies... Colleges, companies, you know, business owners, anyone, homeowners, renters, anyone, they probably don't know the law. And they will try and do everything under the sun to make sure that they'll try and get away with it. And they won't do what's legal. See, there's a big interpretation that, okay, if I'm working for you, you're going to do what's legal. More and more as I've grown up and as I've lived, I've seen more and more this is not the case. People will do whatever is illegal as long as they can get away with it, as long as no one speaks out. And there's obviously incentives for people not to speak out. Hey, you know, you keep your job, which in this economy, you definitely need the money. So you're very less likely to speak out. It's sort of like, okay, do I shoot myself to better everyone else? Most of the time, it's no. But the fact of the matter is, a lot of companies, my own included, a couple ones I've been with, they do definitely illegal shit and no one calls them out on it either because one, they assume it's not illegal because then the company wouldn't be doing it, or two, because they're scared to say anything. And it's fucking disgusting. The fact that a college would do this and some of the people I've worked with would do this, it's actually crazy. And then they feign ignorance and then they apologize, but realistically, they know and we know. It's fucking stupid. Next.
If workers at the bottom get the increase in the minimum wage that President Obama proposed in his State of the Union message, they will still be faring less well than their counterparts did 50 years ago.
That's oh, here's a good one.
Say to you, the peak for the minimum wage.
So this is Richard Wolff. This guy, apparently he has like a PhD or something, I don't know, but He is very against capitalism. It's like, holy shit, this guy hates capitalism.
In terms of its real purchasing power was 1968. It's been basically declining with a couple of ups and downs.
That's true. That's provable and true.
If you adjust for the current price, the minimum wage was about $10.50, roughly, back in 1968. In terms of and it's $7.25 today in terms of what it can buy.
In terms of what it could buy. So I'm going to stop the video here just to add my little anecdote. It is so crazy because I've actually seen this again in my own personal life, and I feel like other people have too. And if you have any situation in your life that relates to anything I'm showing, please put it in the comments below. We need that algorithm to push us up to more viewers, even though I think we're shadow banned. But it doesn't matter. So essentially in my life, from what I've seen, right, what is being said here is something that we've all felt and we've all heard. And it really hit home for me when I was shopping at Key Food, right? I was shopping at Key Food and, you know, prices keep going up and up and up. You know, recession this, war in Ukraine that, inflation, COVID, yada, 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 right? So I was at the market and this guy said $100 is basically the new $20. It doesn't get you anything anymore. Like, it's crazy. Like, it was so crazy to think that. Like, this old guy was like enlightened. He was like, this is ridiculous, this is stupid. Back in the day, $100 could get you insane amounts of stuff. Today it's like the new $20. 100 is literally the new 20, and I fully believe that.
You've taken the folks at the bottom, the people who work hard,
oh yes,
jobs,
yep,
and you've made their economic condition worse,
and it's keep getting worse. It's gonna keep getting worse
while wealth has accumulated at the top.
It is so sad, the wealth inequality in the richest country in the world. And that's something that hopefully we're going to see echoed over and over and over again. The wealth inequality in this country, the wealthiest people are the richest they've ever been. As far as I know in history, the only other person in history that I don't think we've gotten to his wealth is the guy who owned all the gold in Africa way back when. I think he's the only person who we're not as wealthy as. I think that's Mansa Musa. I don't remember though. But everyone else, like all the other people, we haven't seen these levels of wealth like in our history. It's fucking crazy. And they are so wealthy and we have so much wealth. But at the bottom, the people at the bottom are so far worse off. The inequality gap, it's just increasing and it's disgusting. It shows human nature in this dark dimension.
Society does this.
Yeah, what kind does this?
Which are, in my profession, a major staple for many careers. Are arguments that, gee, if you raise the minimum wage, a few people who might have otherwise gotten a job won't get it because the employer doesn't want to pay the higher wage. Well, if that logic...
Also, the other logic behind this is that if you raise minimum wage, prices are just going to go up anyway.
...is really going to play in your mind, then you should keep lowering the wage. Because if you only made it $4 an hour, just think how many more people could get a job.
Now, this is something I want to show here. I'm going to let it finish, but...
But a job under conditions that make life impossible.
So this is where I definitely want to put out that even though I'm showing a lot of these videos about certain ideas, I don't necessarily agree with all the ideas, even though I do like most of them. I generally like Richard Wolff here, but this is where I'm just going to disagree with him, right? He's saying, oh, well, you know, if raising the wage doesn't work out because people are going to hire less, then why don't they lower it? Well, you know, they're obviously not going to do that because who's going to want to work for a lower wage if everyone doesn't do it en masse, right? And there's also set standard minimums, which, you know, I've made my opinions on that on this channel before, but there's set standard minimums that they can't go below. So obviously you can't go to $4 an hour. Like, is this guy dumb? He's obviously not dumb, but I'm just saying that because I'm upset. Excuse me. But that's the part I don't really understand or and don't agree with him on. It's like, bruh, obviously they can't do that for multiple reasons. That's just a stupid arguing point. I take it as intellectually dishonest because you're trying to play on the stupid people who won't look at it like I did. Because I'm smart. No, I'm just joking. I'm stupid too. Next!
Let's title this one, Things Elected Officials Aren't Supposed to Say, number, I don't know, 80.
I actually don't remember this one. So the time period of when I sent these to myself, it's been pretty fucking long. So I actually don't remember most of these, but this one's not too long. So let's see what it is. So I actually don't remember this, so this is kind of like a first reaction for me again until my memory gets jogged of it. So let's see.
I want give people a little bit of a glimpse into all the backroom politics that still exist. Yes,
I think I remember this one.
What better way to showcase this?
So this one just shows in this dark dimension, human greed and human fucking pettiness is just out of this world. Now, I'm a little guilty of this. I'm pretty greedy and I'm pretty petty, but I try and keep it to myself, so.
And to tell you exactly what I've gone through the past year and specifically the past couple months. So in my case, I'm a city council person and
she's
got all this
too.
ARPA funding for our city, right? Your city man.
Look at this. Look at this. Ready? Watch this. I remember this exactly now.
Revitalized your city. And
they got COVID money.
Fun thing where he gave each council person, there's six of us, $200,000 to help revitalize the district. How they.
So $200,000 each, right? So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So that's $1 million and 200,000. $1,200,000 essentially was given out, right? For these people to revitalize their district. Now, I'm gonna be honest, $200,000, that's not chump change for individuals, but to revitalize a whole district, that doesn't seem like it's gonna help too much. It feels like it's gonna be a drop in the bucket personally, but it's something, right? It's something.
They see fit. And immediately, somebody in my district was like, hey, I have this building, my personal building, I want it renovated. How do I apply for this? I kept reiterating that that's not how this district money can be used, and it needs to be something for the public to have access.
Oh my god. If I had a face cam, you would just see my face. I'm literally face palming right now. Like, this is so wild that a public figure, a public council person asked this. Like, oh my god. I have some things to say about this.
And it doesn't go to just one person's personal property or personal business. He kept asking them, and so did his girlfriend.
Like, the fact that they're asking this alone means, who the fuck are these council people? Who do they represent? Like, these people are not for the people. Oh my god. This is, like, the fact that they kept pushing it too. They're so greedy.
And then there was another day where this same man then comes into my coffee shop and brings me an envelope full of cash and hands it to me. I'm like, what is this? And it's like, I'd like to order a coffee. Okay. So then
okay, I love her reaction. Okay.
And I'm like, maybe he wants to pay it forward. So I start paying it forward and I bring him the change after a couple orders. And he's like, no, it's for you. I'm like, nope, absolutely not. You know, I leave
wise on her.
Shop, I come back,
wise
and this
on
money
her.
Is now stuffed behind my coffee bar. You know, knowing how persistent they've been, it was just very bizarre to also have this given to me.
Bruh.
I just didn't like what was happening. I eventually, finally, I can't find him, but I send a money order back with a letter saying, hey, Character Coffee's not accepting donations at this time. I sent that March 27th. The next day.
So remember, we can all chalk it up to a coincidence, but look at what happened the next day.
This same man and his girlfriend were making posts about, can't wait to flip the council, new people are coming, we need to get rid of this corruption.
Oh my god, this boils my fucking blood. It is action set. I'm actually getting angry at this, and I remember why. I remember, like, watching this initially, because this initially made me angry. Stuff like this, people like this, who are corrupt, who try to do things selfishly for themselves when they represent other people, right? And then they try and corrupt the good ones. And when they're not corrupted, they pretend they're the good ones and paint them out as the evil ones, saying, oh, we need to get rid of you because you're the bad one, when they're the fucking scum of the fucking earth. This shit boils my blood. If I was in power, what I would do to these people? Obviously nothing violent, but I would get them out of office as fast as possible, publicly shame them, and make sure they're working at the lowest fucking low of a job that they can work, at the minimum wage that's set, so they can learn what it is to represent the people, or to work like the people they represent and they're stealing from. This is fucking disgusting. Oh my god, I hate this.
Blah, blah, blah. So, yeah, I know. That's just politics, right?
The fact that that's just politics and that's what's accepted is so fucking... It just shows everything's broken. We are in a dark dimension and it's broken.
Anyone's allowed to run for any reason, even if it means they didn't get money for their personal project. So I knew a primary was coming, likely from them. It's to be expected. But what I didn't expect was my city committee to endorse that woman.
The girlfriend
of the man who's doing all this. For all I've done for the district this past year also. But the crazy part is, I did have the endorsement actually. But then backroom politics happens, and we're going to need a part two, because there's no way I'm going to fit this all in.
It's actually crazy. It's so sad how the good ones just get shitted on. I was actually talking about this with Hairline recently, where it's like, What if the bad people, because obviously the bad, selfish, sick fuck people, they rule the world, right? What if they've put it into society, this idea that, hey, you know, being good is the right thing to do. We should strive to be good, this, this, and that. Because it feels like good people just get taken advantage of, and all the people at the top are not good people. And they keep this idea going that being good is good, right? That it's something we should strive for, just because they benefit off of it, and that's how the cycle continues, right? They convince us that being good and not being selfish is the right thing to do because that keeps them on top. I honestly think that at this point, because good people just get trampled on, and it's so fucking sad. But yeah, this one pissed me the fuck off. Oh my god, this was a good one.
Hey, everybody.
Let me actually see how long we're going for. Okay, we're at like the 30-minute mark. I'll go a little longer. We'll make this a long one today.
Just finished dealing with a...
I think... Was this the guy who did the rent thing? No, it wasn't. Here we go. This is about like the doctor sector, which we saw last time about how expensive the hospital stuff is because insurance is evil. But let's see this.
Insurance thing at work. And
oh.
I thought this was a good time to remind everybody that health insurance companies don't care about you.
And by further extension, your job most likely doesn't care about you, and they just care about making a profit. And even though it is directly not related to what we're saying here, which is, you know, about insurance and health stuff, companies, I'll bring in this little anecdote here, right? When you get hired to a company, they expect you to give your 2-week notice, right? When you're leaving so they can replace you, because it's the quote-unquote nice thing to do. When they fire you, I know this might exist in very limited situations, but again, we're talking about the more common ones. The main thing that happens is when you leave, they want you to give 2 weeks. When they fire you, they don't give you a fucking day. They tell you, get the fuck out. Like, you can't work till the end of the week. You can't work till 2 weeks. You know, then you'll get a job. You could start looking while you stay here and we'll, you know, you're on your way out. No, just get out. You're done. We don't want you anymore. Bye-bye. Right? This whole thing baffles me how it's not a two-way street. It's very nasty. It's very disgusting.
They don't care. United, Aetna, Cigna, Blue Cross.
I know a lot of these. Oh, yeah.
They don't care about you.
The more and more I hear about insurance, the more and more I think it's a total fucking scam. And these people are fucking, like, just evil. Now, it's not a total scam. That's actually false for me to say, right? I think insurance, it does help in certain situations. It obviously helps you save money in extreme fringe scenarios, right? If you get into a really bad accident, you're going to have to fucking suck the cock of the insurance company to get them to actually pay out. But at the end of the day, they're most likely going to pay out and you're going to end up saving money. However, those are in the extreme scenarios in the, you know, knock on wood, the scenarios that never happen to anyone. But at the end of the day, those scenarios are more rare than they're not, and the majority of people will just be paying into insurance and nothing serious will happen to them. So either A, insurance will be getting quote-unquote free money, or at least, you know, somewhat free money, easy money. And then when something not too serious happens, they're going to fight tooth and nail to not pay for it for you. It's like, what the fuck is the whole point of this?
They want to extract as much money as possible from your healthy body.
Yup.
Then when you're no longer healthy, they want you to die as quickly as possible.
How fucking sick is that?
To make room for other money-producing bodies.
They just want to milk us. We're not even seen as people anymore.
So, have a great day.
I don't think I can after that, Dr. Glaucome Flecken. What the hell? Dude, this is sad, right? Now, this kind of just echoes what I said, and I just included it in here. I guess I sent it to myself. I have to, like, think why the past self just sent this to me. I think it just echoes just what a lot of people are saying, that insurance is evil. And I'm pretty sure down the line, if we continue reacting, we're going to find more videos that are just straight dead evil about insurance, because insurance is just really, really evil. And the best part is, look at all the comments, right? Look at all the comments. Another doctor who's verified, right? 1.2 million followers. He agrees. He says this is facts. I work in medical billing. You know, we can't always take what these people are saying and who they are as, you know, they're actually telling the truth. She might not even work in medical billing, but I'm assuming they are because I hear it enough where people who say they work in medical billing, enough of them say it and they all say it's true, where it's like, Jesus Christ, look, oncology, 100%. As someone who works in health insurance verification, yes. All these people, like, this is the thing that baffles me. And this is where media comes in. And I'm really, really happy in some senses that I took media as a major, because it sort of opened my eyes. And I know I sound like a crazy person. I used to think these are the people who are crazy too. But, you know, as time got on and I got older, I saw things for what they really were. This is where, if everyone knows this is the case and everyone agrees that this is bad, but this is the way it is, right? How have we not changed it yet? It's because they have a grip on us, where even though we're more connected than ever by the internet, this, this, and that, we are more incapable of doing anything because we're in shambles, our society is in shambles, except for the rich. And we are just, they have like a chokehold on us in terms of media. Again, the first video I showed really shows off how much they influence us in ways we don't even realize. And then even when we do, I don't know what's happened where we just don't care. I mean, probably because we have all these other issues of we can't afford to know if we lose our job next month, where we're going to be living at, if it's going to be in the park or if it's going to be in an apartment. You know, society is so shit that we all know what's happening. We all know it's bad. We all agree that this is, like, wrong, but we can't change it. It's so fucking sad. Oh, this one. Okay.
Coming to bed, honey?
Oh my god, okay, this one just hurts me. I sent this to make fun of myself. Oh my god. So this is, oh my god, it's so sad. It's so sad. I swear to god, this is why I say we're in the dark dimension, right? This is why, like, again, I don't understand how things are the way they are if they're so bad, because things can be so much better. Things can be so much better if, you know, the people in power wanted it to, but because they're greedy, because that's human nature, it's just not. Again, we don't have to have things be the way they are. Back in the day, back when there wasn't enough to go around because we didn't have enough technological advancements or enough of a population working or enough output or enough raw materials, this and that, right? I can understand why things were bad. But today, those problems are mostly solved. They're mostly arbitrary. And the fact that this is how it is, it's just miserable because, the people at the top, you know, it's hard to even put a name to it, but most of the people at the top who have above a certain amount of money, they're the ones who are keeping it this way. I feel like that's honestly what it is. When you graduate college, have a job, eat healthy, exercise regularly, have a daily routine, set health boundaries, and learn how to communicate effectively, right? Look, doesn't this look so happy? Doesn't this look so happy? This is how it is for most of us. And the worst part is social media makes you think that if you're in this, you're bad, you're evil, you're not good enough. Because all social media shows you is the less than 1% that this is not their life. And they have an actual good life. They have a happy life, whether it's from their privilege of having money or their, you know, their hard work of getting out of this, you know, depression loop. Of, you know, which we call society, they show you that. That's the only thing they show you, and it makes you think this is not normal, or if it is normal, like, you're the loser. Wait, this is how it is for regular people. I'm not saying anyone's a loser if they live this life, right? Because I'm living this life too, but I feel like I'm a loser, not because of this life, because of other things. However, it's sad that we have such a warped view of things where, number one, I think this should not be the baseline. This should change, and it easily can if people wanted it to. But the fact that, like, I don't know, it's just so sad that this is the way it is. And people think if you're in this way, I mean, the way it is now should not be what we set as the standard, but it's not that bad compared to, you know, history. But the fact that people feel like losers by doing this, it's just really sad because social media just leads to comparison, which leads to bad stuff.
These are 10 facts.
Okay. This is the Ohio train crash. We could skip this one. Okay, this one's a good one too. We have a hot, sexy lady dancing. Oh my lord. Oh my lord. Whoa. So let's read the little caption here. Boomers affording a house, a new car, eating out every meal, and saving thousands, making $2.45 an hour in 1984. So again, you know, not everything I put on here is to prove a point. I actually disagree with a lot of the things that I send myself, and this is one of them. This is where, and yeah, the comments are so fucking funny, by the way. Like, holy shit, they're just fiending over this lady. But this is where they're kind of taking the reality to an extreme here. Obviously, they couldn't afford a house and do all this shit on $245 an hour in 1984. That's just fucking impossible. But regardless of that, it is true to a point where they made a lot less than we did. Their minimum wage was lesser than we did. But again, with the previous video from before that I showed, even though it was less money than we earn today, it was able to buy more. It had more buying power. So, you know, it just echoes again. This is more of an echo video. I'm going to include a lot of these that are just going to echo the same things. And hopefully it shows you that these aren't just one-off things. They're actually things that are, you know, talked about more often than not, unfortunately. But yeah, people in the past were definitely had it better than we did. And the sad part is people don't believe that, even though it's sort of provable with math at this point, where people back then had it easier. And then people from back then, a lot of them tell us, oh, just work harder. Oh, you just don't want to work. You don't have it that bad. We had to work this, this, and that. You know, times are different. Obviously, I don't know how it is from their times. We don't know. They don't know how it is in our times. I think our times are a little bit worse, but who knows? Who knows?
Sick a 40-hour work week is.
40?
Oh, my God. Yo, this is what I was talking about, too. This perfectly shows what I was talking about. Oh, my God.
Hours. How many of you heard in your head? 40 hours.
Look at this egghead.
Part-time job.
Italian Marxist philosopher. Look, he says part-time job. He thinks 40 hours a week is a part-time job.
Antonio Gramsci used the term cultural hegemony to describe one of the key ways that the ruling class dominates society. And this is exactly what he was talking about.
Yeah, this fucking bald egghead.
Gramsci argued that physical dominance was not enough for the ruling class.
Yeah, you could beat them, but beating doesn't break them enough.
...to maintain power. They needed to maintain a cultural form of dominance as well. So he used the term hegemony to describe the ways in which the ruling class creates an ideology in which their values become common sense for the rest of society.
So again, this relates to what I said before. Their values become common sense to the rest of society, right? Their values of we can profit off good people, so let's convince people to be good because we can step on them and remain profitable and remain in power. I feel like that is a cultural hegemony right there.
According to Gramsci, the goal of this dominant...
Fuck. 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 I did my mouse wrong. Fuck. Fuck. God damn it. I apologize.
40 hours. How many of you heard...
Gramsci argued the class creates an ideology in which their values become common sense for the rest of society. According to Gramsci, the goal of this dominant culture is for the working class to develop a concept of freedom and a good life that serves the purposes of the ruling class.
Yep.
In today's day and age, this is what cultural hegemony looks like.
Oh, yeah.
40 hours is a hobby.
Uh-huh.
That's not even a job. That's a hobby.
Oh, yeah.
To be very clear, I have no disrespect for this man. In fact, I like this guy. I appreciate his willingness to work hard for the people he cares about.
But see, it's sad because they do represent, just like this guy says, like, I ultimately just feel bad for these people, right? Because they probably had to bust their ass and work very hard, but it sort of becomes like a thing of salt, right? They're salty that people are complaining that we're doing less because they did more in their time. You know, I think we, or not all of us, but most of us are guilty of this too, where if we see someone having it easier than us and they're complaining, we kind of get a little upset. And it's sad that that's like a human thing, but just because they have it easier than us and just because we had it harder doesn't mean either situation should be taken as the baseline. It shouldn't. Just because his thing is easier doesn't mean it's still the ideal. I honestly think we're going towards, you know, from what I hear, who knows when this is going to come out, right? We're going towards a 32-hour work week. You know, hopefully, I doubt it's going to happen in the U.S., but I've been hearing more and more good things about it, so maybe it's going to pick up traction, but even then, it all goes into the question of how much should and does a person need to work. Taking away the money aspect, because money, obviously, it's not being paid enough already, right? But aside from the money aspect, right, like I said before, we have enough materials, we have enough structure being built, we have enough technological output, both in terms of agriculture, technology, this, this, and that, where not everyone needs to work. We have to work because we need money, but that's a self-imposed thing by society at this point, because people in the top want to stay rich. But it's sad. It's very sad. I feel bad for him.
You see people like him pushing hustle culture? Ask yourself.
Fuck hustle
culture.
When we
imagine our self-worth in terms of productivity,
that's
who does
really
that really
bad.
Serve? It
Not
serves
us.
The people who are profiting off of your time. So
yep.
My friend, if you want more of that wealth to go to you, which it should, join a union.
Facts. What a great ending to that. Join a fucking union. Join a union. Unions are great. It's a shame that they're illegally getting busted, but, you know, a bunch of illegal stuff is happening in the world. But anyway, I'm going to say we're going to end it here. We could go more. I love doing these. It's very easy for me to do, and I actually enjoy doing them. But just for brevity's sake, because we've been at this for 45 minutes now, and I've kind of digested a lot of my food, and I'm hungry again, and I want to eat, and I don't want to do it on stream. Or not on stream, on this video. We'll end it here. But anyway, I hope everyone enjoyed. Again, please, 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 if you made it to the end of this video, if you made it to the end of this 45 session, thank you so much. But also, please tell me what you liked, what you disliked. Do you want to see the long videos? Do you want to see the short ones more? Please tell me what you enjoyed. And again, I'm live every day, Twitch.tv/Tecnics channel, where I play games and I complain there. And you can come and hang out with me. But I hope you enjoyed, and that will be it for the second episode of the Dark Dimension TikToks.